have submitted a comprehensive sustainability plan. Now, that plan is the subject of further engagement with relevant departments in government. And those engagements are continuing. I did indicate that we are hopeful that there will be a common solution that is found. But we are not waiting for government to come with solutions. We are already implementing components of that plan, and one of which is the business productivity plan. The second one that we touched on briefly is our expansion into exploiting other fuels, alternative to coal, for example, gas.
We are looking at a number of solutions, as he has indicated, one of which is our business productivity program, as well as we've been saying, we do need to look at the cost reflectivity of tariffs, because we believe that we are not recovering the cost of supply. And essentially, we are working with government, as I indicated, National Treasury, the Department of Public Enterprises, as well as the Department of Energy, to look at other funding alternatives that are available for us. Because as I indicated, from our perspective, it is important that we earn adequate returns to maintain and replace our assets, but also are liquid in the short term. We are liquid in this financial year. We have made profits in this financial year, but we have to have a long-term view. We do need to look at Eskom's financial sustainability in the long term, beyond the 12 months moving forward. Because as we continue to keep the lights on, as we continue to conclude our bill program and do all the things we need to do, Eskom has to be financially sustainable. With regards to, I think, the issue of the capital injection as well, that is the issue that is part of our financial sustainability solution that we are discussing and engaging with government on. As soon as that is ready for sharing with the public and everyone else, I'm sure government will do that in due course.